Hey there, Jon Chorba here from reallyeasyguitarlessons.com, and in this video lesson, I'm going to walk you through how to play Corduroy by Pearl Jam. So as you can see by the albums and books and stuff that I got on my shelf, I'm a pretty big Pearl Jam fan. I've seen them live quite a few times, and they've played Corduroy live quite a few times. So it's a great song for beginner guitar players on the rock side. It's mostly made up of just power chords and open position chords. There's some spots that could be somewhat challenging because chords are changing on upbeats, and if you're not used to that sort of thing, it could give you a challenge if you're on the really, really new side. But for most, you know, all intents and purposes, again, it's just power chords and a couple open position chords. So, you know, again, great for the beginner guitar player. When Pearl Jam plays this live, they definitely don't stay faithful to the album recording. They take some rhythmic liberties, and I'll point that out as we go through it. So I'm working off the Vitalogy version of this song. I'm going to start at the beginning of it, work our way through all of it, point out what all the guitar parts are happening on the song. There's two or three of them in spots. Mostly, it's just a double of what the main guitar part is. So with that said, let's get started. Okay, let's start with the intro. So on the recording, the song fades in, right? So the you know, guitar is playing, but you don't quite hear it until a few seconds into it as the audio comes up to full volume. On the recording, on the Vitalogy recording, the intro sounds like this. Okay, so all that is, it's a power chord on the 7th fret of the A and D string. So my index is on 7 of the A, and my ring finger is on 9 of the D, all right? And I'm picking just those two notes. The first one. Da, 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 da. And then I just lift my index finger off of the string, exposing the open string, and play the exact same rhythm. Now, I'm doing this with down and upstrokes. If you could do it with all downstrokes if you want to. All right, I just feel the down and the up make a little more sense, especially when we talk about how we could vary the intro to match kind of what Eddie does live. So again, on the recording, you're just repeating those two chord ideas, the power chord with, you know, on the 7th fret, and then taking your index finger off and playing the same rhythm. And then the last thing he does before the verse starts is take your hold your ring finger on that D string of the 9th fret, and then take your middle finger and put it on the 8th fret of the E string. And when you do this, you can mute out the A string. So you get this last thing, and you could, you know, sometimes when he plays it live, you know, he'll strum it like a chord, or he'll play just the same rhythm he did with the other notes. Okay. So if you're a big Pearl Jam fan like me, you've heard live versions of this, you know that sometimes that the rhythm of that riff can be varied, right? Sometimes I've heard it like this. Right, you could get aggressive towards the end there where he's playing the same chords, just instead of picking them, he's doing some strumming on them. All right, and now we're into the verse, and I'm just gonna go ahead and play along with it, and then I'll break it down for you. So all we got going on here, we got three chords. Power chord at the 8th fret of the A and D and G string, which is an F. And then a power chord on the 7th fret of the A string, which is an E. And then a G power chord, but we're playing it more like a G open chord. So here my middle finger is on the E string of the third fret. I'm letting it mute the A string. D and G strings are open. And then my ring finger is playing the B and the E string. So it's kind of a G, it's like the AC/DC G. I've heard it referred to as that because AC/DC does it a lot. It is a power chord. It's just more of like an open power chord. All right, so F, E, G. F, E, G. So those are the chords. And if you don't, you know, if you're new to playing and your chord changes aren't that great, you might need to just do what I'm doing right now, which is simply moving between them and getting faster with getting your fingers to where they need to be. Rhythmically, the first thing you're doing is you're starting with a muted note on a down strum and catching that F on an up. And then you follow with another down up. So it's down up on the F. It's just the first one is muted. And then a muted rest up on the seventh fret power chord. And then move to the G, which, oh, sorry, you're gonna hit that with an up. So you're like, there, all these things are happening on upstrokes. Up, up. And notice as I'm changing between them, I'm hitting the strings with a downstroke. You're just not hearing anything besides a percussive sound. And then when you get to that G chord, hold it out. And then when you're bringing the riff back around, there's another down up at the end of it. Now again, live, I've seen Eddie change it where he plays the F up here in the open position, like so. And then it looks like it goes to an E minor and then to that G. So it's the same chord, same idea, just same chord names, but different chord shapes. And the other two guitars are basically playing the exact same thing. They might accent that G chord differently in spots, but for most parts, it's the same thing. And then we get into the chorus, which is going to sound like this. I'll play along with it. So it's interesting because like the chorus kind of starts on the last measure of the verse. It's just a couple chords. We have a C sus 2, which is almost like a C add 9. So my in this chorus, keep your ring and your pinky on the third fret of the B and the E string. We're just going to manipulate our index and middle fingers. So the C sus 2, A string third fret with the middle finger. D string is open, and then again, G string is open, and then the B and the E are covered by the ring and the pinky. So there's our C sus 2. Then we have a G over B, which is go take that middle off and put your index on the second fret of the A. That's your G over B. And then make an A power chord. So I'm using my index finger to hold down the second fret of the D and the G string. Play the open A. And then the last one is our G like we did before. So C, G over B, A, G. C, G over B, A, G. All right. Pearl Jam does that a lot. There's a couple Pearl Jam songs that have that little progression in it. Anyway, but strumming-wise, now we're going to go... On the C, down, up, change to the G, and it's down, up there, so. the little pause, hit that A power chord with an upstroke, down, mute, to the G. Da 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 ah. Again, that A changes on an upbeat. And then on that G, on the tab, I have just up, down, but I tend to play up, down, up, like that. So if you hear me do that, sorry, I can't break the habit. Da, da. So C, G, A, G, da, da. And then just repeating that. Let's see, you repeat that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times. Is that right? Let's see. 1, 2, 3, sorry, 4 times. I didn't think it was 5. So on the 4th time, you just hang out on the G. And then with the chorus, the other guitar parts are pretty much following that. There is just one little thing that you hear when you go to the G chord. You'll hear a, instead of having the 3rd fret be covered on the E string, if you leave it open and play the high E string, 3rd fret of the B, open G string, right there, you get that sound here. I'll play this part along with it so you can hear it. All right, and then we have a break, which is just playing the chords of the intro. The E, the A, and then this C thing, right? Power chord with the A string open. Same, keep that 9th fret held out. 8th fret of the E, mute the E. And it's all 8th notes. But you want to listen for accents, right? Right, I'm not hitting all the strings with the same emphasis all the time. It's not completely. I mean, you could do it that way, but it sounds better if you add emphasis on certain beats. All right, and then you're into the second verse, which is the same as the first. And then you're into the second chorus, which is the same as the first. So you don't have to go over anything again. You just play the exact same thing that you did in the first verse and then in the first chorus. And then we get to a bridge. So let's take a look at that. So excuse me, I said that the second chorus was the exact same as the first chorus. It is in terms of what you play. However, it's a little bit longer, right? The first one, when you went through that pattern 4 times. In the second chorus, I believe you go 8 times before you jump to the bridge. You're still playing the same stuff. It just goes a bit longer. And in the bridge, I will play along with it. There's 2 distinct guitar parts. All right, bridge guitar part 1, very simple. You're just doing your G over B, and then you're doing your C sus 2. All right, G over B for two measures, C sus two for two measures, and I'm playing eighth notes. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and change. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and. All downstrokes. Again, I would listen and try to put some accents in. Yep. All right, it's not all just straight downstrokes evenly. You want to add some emphasis in spots. But the other little part that you hear in the bridge, I'll play along with it. It's just doing a D to a D sus 4. All right, so a D, regular D chord looks like that. If you add your pinky to the high E string of the third fret, that's a D sus 4. So I'm just going between those two chords, and it sounds like this. So, dun 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 dun. Just lifting that pinky off. D sus 4 to D, back to sus 4. And then you're into the last chorus of the song, which abruptly ends and then transitions right into a verse. I'll play along with it. All right, so that third chorus, it's, you know, it's played the same as all the other ones. It's just you end it on an A and transition right back to the verse. There's the A and then right back to the verse. Right, which you're gonna do that verse pattern one, two, three, four times. And on that fourth time, don't go to the G. End it on the E. It hangs right there on the E at the end of it. And then we're at the outro of the song where main guitar is playing the intro riff. All right, so that's what one guitar is doing, and doing that up until it builds into the main part of the outro where the riff then becomes just chords. And on the Vitalogy version, there is another guitar that's playing a bar chord, an E minor bar chord here at the seventh fret. And he goes from the E minor bar chord to an E sus 2 and back to the E minor, and he's just rotating between those two chords. I'll play along with it so you can hear it. And there is a little bit of a lead at the end of this, but I'm not even going to bother with it simply because if you're going to play a lead at the end of the song, you should go full Mike McCready and rip out a E minor pentatonic improvised exquisite jam of awesomeness. All right, so yeah, there is some like little lead stuff going on up here, you know, and then he does a little thing down here, but it's the song starts to fade out. I'm not going to go crazy with what is going on in here. In the future, I will do a transcription of a good Mike McCready live solo. So if you have a favorite solo of yours that he played live and would like me to transcribe it and instruct it, let me know. I'd be happy to hear your input of what your favorite McCready solo is on Corduroy. So you see, it's pretty straightforward, just using some power chords and some open chords. Not that hard to get your head around. The hardest part probably about it, again, is those chord changes happening on the upbeats can give students some problems when you're on the newer side of things. But just like with anything, take it slow as you need to do it. Break things down into small little chunks. Work on one little chunk at a time. And then, of course, stack your chunks. So that's it for this video lesson. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like and subscribe button to get more videos like this. If you are a beginner or intermediate guitar player and you are totally lost, confused, overwhelmed, not sure what you should be working on, head over to reallyeasyguitarlessons.com/quiz where you can take my free guitar practicing assessment. I'll ask you a few short questions, and then based off of your answers, I will tell you what your top practicing priorities are. You could find that at reallyeasyguitarlessons.com/quiz. It's totally free. Results are delivered instantly. Again, reallyeasyguitarlessons.com/quiz. Thank you again for watching, and I'll see you next time.